enjoyed our little song. I am so excited to be here today to teach Sunday school with you guys and share a message with you this morning. I sure am missing you all a lot, but I'm also enjoying our lessons that we've had from Mr. Bryant and Miss Katie and Miss Hannah, and I hope that you guys have too. I know that we'll see each other as soon as we can. Also, happy Mother's Day to our moms. I hope you guys have a wonderful day with your families. I'm going to start today with a game that is sort of like the game I Spy. Have you guys ever played I Spy? I want you, in just a second, to press pause and go find something in your house that is the color purple. Okay, so press pause now and go find your purple item. Was that easy or hard to find something purple? I kind of found out when Nate did this activity that we don't have a lot of purple items in our house, but he did find an action figure. So we're talking about the color purple today because of a woman in the Bible named Lydia. She is from the book of Acts. One of the main themes of the book of Acts is spreading the good news of Jesus to the world, including the people who were not Jewish. Paul went to the river looking for a place of prayer, and that's where he met Lydia. Lydia was a successful business person, which was a rare accomplishment for a woman at this time in history. She sold purple cloth, which meant she would have been in contact with the wealthy and important people of that area who wore and could afford clothing made of the expensive purple dye. Did you know that purple dye was really expensive way back then? Lydia had a lot of influence. And this story is important because it shows us that God calls on everyone, even people seen by many as less important, like women in those days. He calls on everyone, though, because he knows that all people have gifts, like Lydia, who used her resources and influence to share Jesus with others. I'm going to read the story now to find out, we'll find out more about how Lydia used her gifts to spread Jesus' love. I'm going to try to hold it so you guys can see the pictures. Paul traveled to many places, teaching people about Jesus. One night, God told Paul, "Go to another country and teach people there." Paul listened to God. He got onto a big boat. Up and down, over the waves, the boat went, sailing to a faraway country. When he got there, Paul taught, "Jesus loves you," he said. "Jesus came to earth to teach us how to live and has saved us from all our sins." An amazing woman named Lydia heard Paul teaching. Unlike many other women of that time, Lydia had her own business. She sold beautiful, expensive purple cloth to rich and famous people. Lydia said to Paul, "Tell me more about Jesus. I want to learn everything I can about the Son of God." Paul told her about Jesus' teachings. "Love everyone," he said. "Share with others," he continued. "And most importantly," he finished, "remember that God loves you forever." Lydia was amazed. "I want to be one of Jesus' followers," she exclaimed. "Will you baptize me and everyone who lives in my house?" Lydia, Paul, and all of the people who lived in Lydia's house went to the water. They splashed into the cool wetness. Paul baptized each of them. "I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." Lydia said, "Thank you. Will you stay at my house with my family?" Paul said, "Sure," and went to stay with Lydia. Lydia became a follower of Jesus. She was very generous, using her money to help many people. "Jesus loves you," she told as many people as she could. "Jesus has saved you from your sins. Follow Jesus. He is the Son of God." Many people learned from Lydia, the amazing woman who sold purple cloth. And there she is getting baptized. Next, we're going to move on to our leaflet. And if you printed it, we will be using the side with the two circles on it, the two plates. And if you didn't print it, that's okay. You can get a blank sheet of paper and just draw two big circles, like plates, on there. So if you want to pause it real quick and go get a blank sheet of paper, that would be just fine. Or you can use your leaflet. So in our story, we just learned from our story that Lydia gave a lot to Paul and her church. She was one of the first leaders. You can give too. Just because you're young doesn't mean you can't help our church. In the first circle on your leaflet, at the top, we're going to write a list or draw pictures of things that you do well. For example, if you like to read out loud, you could read scripture at church. If you like to meet people, you can ask to be a greeter. Or if you like to sing or play an instrument, you can provide music for our service. Also, another example is if you're really clean and tidy, you can help clean up the sanctuary after worship. Those are all ways that you can share with our service. And in the second circle on the bottom, we're going to write or draw things that you own that you can give to the church. Maybe you can give part of an allowance as an offering. Or maybe you have extra food or toys or clothes at home that you could donate. Or maybe you could even write a letter to somebody at church who you think might be lonely right now to brighten their day. There's lots of things that we can do to help out our church, just like Lydia did. If you want to pause now to work on your leaflet, feel free. I bet you guys came up with some really great ideas of how you can use your gifts to help our church. And before we close in prayer, I have one more quick activity that will be really fun for you guys to do with your moms for Mother's Day. I want to tell you how to make a tissue paper flower. Sort of like this. So what you'll need is some tissue paper. I used purple and a little yellow in honor of Lydia, but you can use any color that you have. You can even use more than one color if you want to make it a colorful flower. So you will need to cut about 4 or 5 pieces of tissue paper in a rectangle shape, about as big as my hand, or your mom's hand, or your dad's hand. And you're going to stack them all together, and we're going to fold them like an accordion. I don't know if you can see. So we're going to fold just a little bit up, and then you flip it over and fold it backwards. And then we're going to flip it up and fold it again until we have our accordion of tissue. Then, once you have this, you can tie a pipe cleaner for crafts that a lot of us have. If you don't have a pipe cleaner, you can make a stemless flower by using yarn or string or thread. So we're gonna just cinch up the middle here and tie it tight. And then once you do that, then we have to start separating the pieces of tissue. So you can kind of pull it all around and down and start separating them all until you have a beautiful flower that your mom can enjoy for Mother's Day. Then you can give your mom a big hug and say, Happy Mother's Day. And now I want to close in prayer. Dear God, thank you for Lydia and all the other women who have taught us more about you. We think of women like our moms, grandmas, aunts, friends, sisters, pastors, and teachers. Help us, like them, to use our talents and possessions to serve you. Amen. I hope you have a wonderful week, and I really look forward to seeing you soon.